You are watching the Sunday Motivational Video. 15 moments you experience when you're rich. Welcome to Alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. Hello, Aluxers. It's always great to have you back with us, especially today when we are pulling back the curtains to show you some of what's going on in the life of the rich. By the end of this video, you'll have a much better understanding of what financial stability is like and how rich people are navigating their daily lives. We'll present a series of moments and events that the average person doesn't get to experience, but maybe they should. As you know, sometimes it's the little things that make all the difference. Here are 15 moments you experience when you're rich. Number 1. You no longer keep tabs on the money people owe you. You know how you're constantly aware of how much money people owe you? Well, rich people don't know, because quite frankly, the lack of that particular amount isn't life-altering. Rich people just assume you're a decent person and that whatever debt is there will be repaid if it hasn't already. Nobody wants to be surrounded by leeches, but figuring out who they are can be quite difficult, so this is a rather simple way of figuring out who's who. The cost of ridding yourself of freeloaders is worth it. Number 2. You no longer drive unless it's for pleasure. We're all part of the general traffic, but while you're frustrated with your foot on the brake, barely moving a couple of inches a minute, the rich are in the back on their phones and laptops getting work done. Chauffeuring is something quite common because it frees up time for transit. This is the same reason why rich people take helicopter rides to the airport and then fly private. The only reason you should drive is if it's for personal pleasure. Number 3. Going to events feels more like work than a night out. You know how normal people complain they don't go out enough, or they never go to fancy events? There's a dark side to this as well. Women can be mean, men can be boring, the food starts to taste the same, and everyone wants money from you. These events are meant for networking, to make small talk with other rich people while gossiping about who did what with who. Some nights you don't feel like socializing, but it becomes this weird thing where you have to show up and put on a smile so everyone thinks you're doing incredible. Number 4. You care more about the view from a property than the price. If you're buying for yourself and not as another cash flow investment, priorities shift. You can always buy more space, but you can't always buy a better view. Normal people judge a property price by square foot or square meter, but fail to take into account the view from the entire apartment. If it has a terrace, if you're getting a sunset or a sunrise when you look out the window. If you're going to live in a place, you'll look out that window daily, so it might be smart to remember this for the next time you move. Number 5. You're glad you're going into more debt. We remember when a friend took us out for drinks to celebrate. When asked what we were celebrating, he said, "Going $5 million in debt," and we all cheered to it. He'd just secured bank financing on a property development deal that, when finished, would make him millions. This is the total opposite of everyone living a normal life, because most people actually struggle to get out of debt and not trying to get more of it. Numerous times, the community has reached out with questions about how to get out of debt, and it always depends on the person. Our go-to recommendation is to pick up The Total Money Makeover by Dave Ramsey and go through it 2 to 3 times until you really grasp the gist of it, and then put it into practice. Even better, because you're already in debt and we don't want you to spend money you don't have, if you go to alux.com/freebook and sign up, you'll get the audiobook version for free thanks to our friends at Audible. That's alux.com/freebook and look for The Total Money Makeover. Number 6. You no longer look at the price on a menu. We grew up poor, and this has always been an issue on the once-a-year occasion when we used to go out. There were entire pages in menus we would never look at. Now, the reality is quite different. Duck? Sure. Lobster? Yes, please. Matter of fact, tasting menus with 5 to 8 different kinds of food have become a go-to when it comes to testing new cuisines or a restaurant. And of course, you choose to pair each dish with a different drink for a greater overall experience. The last thing, when the bill comes, you just hand over the credit card, no arguing and pulling out a calculator to see who had what and who had an extra piece of dessert. Number 7. A quick getaway can be on the other side of the world. What do you do when the weather is bad in your city during the weekend? Most people grab their comfy hoodie and chill out in bed, binging Netflix and ordering in. Well, with money, you get more options. Here's a snippet of a conversation we overheard at lunch. There's nothing happening this weekend and the weather is shitty. Wondering what Spain is like, or maybe Portugal. By the time dessert came, they had already bought their tickets and were booking an Airbnb. Number 8. People in hotels put up a family photo in your room. This is one of those things you experience if you frequent five-star hotels. When you book a room, they do research into who you are, what you like, and what your preferences are. They do it so your experience is quite custom. It's not often your room is already prepared for you with personal touches, like a frame with your family, your favorite bottle of wine, or a particular dessert you mentioned you loved last time you visited. Number 9. People in restaurants address you by your name. The same thing happens in a restaurant. If it's one of the high-end places, both the chef and the waiters will be informed of your arrival and will make sure to welcome you by name. They also print your name on the menu with their recommendations based on what they think you'll enjoy most. Number 10. You pay ridiculous amounts of money for education. A decent life coach charges around $1,000 per session and requires you to book multiple ones. Just to give you an example, for an 18-session package with a Tony Robbins-accredited coach, not even with Tony himself, be ready to dish out $15,000. Rich people pay ridiculous amounts of money every time they try to acquire a new skill or seek some guidance. You might think it costs this much because they get access to the best of the best, but that is rarely the case. This business runs on recommendations, and some coaches choose to focus exclusively on the wealthy. Even for an introductory meeting and session, you would still be billed hundreds of dollars. That's why we decided to tackle this industry head-on. We spent an entire year building our first premium product, Mind Mastery, a 21-day meditation program designed to not only teach you how to install this super valuable skill in your life, but also provide the guidance offered by the highest paid performance coaches and for less than what it would cost for an introductory session with these people. It's like a select club for high-performing A-Lexers. That's why we only open the doors 3 times per year. We don't play any games. You can get on that waiting list by going to alux.com/meditation, and we'll let you know when it becomes available once again. Number 11. You travel to a different country because you crave a particular food. I know this sounds crazy, especially since these days you can find almost every kind of food everywhere. But there's something special about eating paella in Barcelona, an Italian meal in Osteria Francescana in Modena, a steak at Don Julio in Argentina, waffles in Brussels, or sushi at Tsukiyabashi Jiro in Tokyo, Japan. For some people, it's enough to justify a quick trip. It's no longer food, it's more of a culinary experience. Number 12. Groceries, cleaning, or bills get taken care of. Imagine never having to bother with these ever again. Your fridge is constantly full with fresh produce, home is constantly sparkling clean, and all of your bills get automatically taken care of. You don't even know how much you pay for utilities per month. It's always a shock for rich people when they lose everything and have to go back to living normal lives. Just how expensive it is to keep things running for a normal household. But let's not bring that negative energy into our zone, okay? Number 13. Other people plan, pack, and organize your life for you. This is one of those things where rich people buy time by delegating others to do work for them. Unless you did it yourself, you have no idea just how crazy it is to plan a wedding, how much work goes into fully designing a house or planning a detailed trip. They have people who take care of the boring things for them, and although there is always the possibility of going off the beaten path, the advisor is almost always right. Number 14. You have one person who takes care of your problems. This is usually the family lawyer or a head of security, someone from your inner circle. It's the person you call when you screwed up. There are many situations where people want to take advantage of the privileged position you find yourself in for personal gain or profit. If it's a legal matter, the lawyers will make sure the situation is clear and you can walk away with the minimum legal penalty, while in cases of blackmail or scandals, it's usually more of a gray area. Speaking of, number 15, you will be misrepresented by the media for clicks. There's nothing like seeing your face in the paper, or for those of us not living in the 19th century, a gossipy site with your words taken out of context with a crazy clickbait title. This happens all the time. News has devolved into only headlines, and publications are struggling to keep their businesses alive, with more and more people getting their news directly from other people via social networks. So they resort to scandal, to controversy, to downright lying, and then apologizing for not looking into the situation further before breaking the story. Some of these are not exclusive to the super rich, so we're curious, what is the craziest rich person moment you've ever lived? Let us know in the comments, and we'll be sure to show some love to the most interesting stories. And for sticking with us until the end, here's your bonus. Number 16. Finding out your partner is only with you for your money. This is a uniquely rich people experience. There's nothing like overhearing a conversation or figuring out your partner is actually digging for gold. You don't want to believe it at first, and your entire world comes crashing down. But it's one of those things you might have to deal with. That's why prenups are a thing, and why we strongly encourage everyone to talk to a lawyer about protecting your assets before jumping into a romantic relationship that's only gonna last 3 years before they cash out with half of your stuff. There are loads of stories on Reddit about people finding out their partner was just in it for the money, which we definitely recommend browsing for your own safety. And if you stuck with us until this point, here are some cool photos we took 3 days ago while in Portofino and Cinque Terre. Please also write Portofino in the comments so we can confuse the hell out of those who never watch until the end. Thank you for being a true Aluxer. Thank you for spending some time with us, Aluxers. Make sure to subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpicked these videos for you to watch next. As always, the conversation continues on social media. Thanks again, and we can't wait to have you back tomorrow.